It's the cough bottle himself, eh? The dead arose and appeared, what?
That's what I said.
Ah, me old flower. Put it there. It's high time you come to see us. We missed you. Are you in form?
I'm told so.
And the hatchet's buried? What? The pipe of peace is lit?
He takes me for a Mohican.
I'm back at the Northlight Theatre again. Very, very happy to be here. The play's called A Life. And basically it's about a lot of things, but a man nearing retirement who finds out he has a terminal illness and goes back over his life to try to repair some bridges that he had burned and to find out exactly what he has made of his life. It's a very, very funny play, having said that, as most Irish plays are, you know. It's kind of like you know, you find yourself laughing in the middle of the most serious moments and crying in the middle of a laugh. It's a wonderful combination of humor and drama.
Have you ever done anything by Hugh Leonard before?
No, I haven't. I have seen his works. I saw Da years and years ago, actually, when it was in with Barnard Hughes, when it was downtown. And then A Life came along, and I remembered seeing that years ago at the Old Body Politic with James O'Reilly. And I was very impressed with it then, and always thought, you know, wait another 50 years, and maybe I can do that part myself, and the time has arrived.
Ah, will you put that back on?
You were told to stop.
Quit acting the maggot. Fair dues now. Give Dolly a dance. Come on.
I warned you.
Sure you did.
I mean it.
Look, don't be such a...
We're here with Robert Belushi. Talk about the character that you play in A Life.
I play Lara Kearns, kind of a Irish idler, village idler, or corner boy, you know. I'd say the town socialite in one light. He's a younger, there are two, as with all the parts in the play, there are two actors playing each.
Son of Jim, mm-hmm. Uncle was John, right. Great comedians, great improvisers. It looks like you're going on a sort of a different career track than they are.
Well, I guess in some ways, you know, in some ways I'm not. You know, people remember the Saturday Night Live aspects or like the more comedic stuff. But when my dad and uncle were in town, you know, they tried to branch out as well. You know, my father worked at the Goodman, he worked at the Apollo. You know, it was important to do everything for him. He got the most success with, you know, the Second City and then Saturday Night Live, and I also, you know, work for the Second City as well. But I just want to do everything.
Hey, cough bottle, how about this for a lion? What?
Kearns.
It's great to have someone to talk to about it, like my father. You know, in fact, he just sent me a telegram, which he does at every opening, which is something that John did for him. So that's kind of a nice, like, tradition.
I ought to borrow the page from your book. Dolly soon found out who the boss was. You used the whip from the first fence. Now she's afraid to look crossways at you.
Is that supposed to be funny?
That's where I slipped up. Too much of a softy.
That remark is untrue and impertinent. Dolly has never been afraid of me.
You were here at Northlight recently with Mike Nussbaum. You had Amy Morton here a while ago directing Awake and Sing.
Yeah.
What's it with all the Steppenwolf Ensemble members coming up to Northlight to work?
Well, you know, I think it's just coincidence. We're being offered great roles.
People paying good money to see you, and you say impossible. Very nice indeed, I don't think.
I don't want to be seen.
Difficult when you're playing King Lear with the lighting you use.
As far as Steppenwolf goes, there's just nothing for my age at the moment. So I'd have gone anywhere. I don't care where I work as long as it's a good script and good actors that I'm working with. But I do have favorites, and this certainly is one of them. I had such a great time doing Better Late, and I was really looking forward to coming back here again.
And what's next for you after A Life?
After A Life, I'm going to be here again next year, doing a wonderful play called The Outgoing Tide, and I'll probably be doing a few more episodes of Burn Notice, and that's about it.
The mustache is for the character?
Mustache is for the character. I started out with a beard, but civil servants didn't grow beards, I don't think, in Ireland in the 70s, so we compromised with the mustache.
All right. Okay. Wonderful. Thank you very much, John.
Thank you.
I do take offense. I despise tyrants, domestic or otherwise.